Hello and welcome to techsith tutorials. Today we are going to learn about a very important method in JavaScript called Object.create. Object.create makes the prototype inheritance possible in JavaScript. And this tutorial is part of a much larger series in object-oriented programming. So if you haven't started from the beginning, you can do so by clicking on a link here. I'll provide it here. Now every object in JavaScript is created from this master object. And the name of this object is object, and it has a capital O, as you can see. So whenever I say object with capital O, which means I'm referring to this master constructor. Now, if I want to look at it, what it is, it's in a global space, so I can use it directly. And I can just simply say console dir. So dir would help me look at this object, master object, in detail. I would see a function. As I said, it's a constructor, which is a function. And if I expand it, I would see a bunch of methods object has. One of the methods is create. So this is what we're going to look at it, create method. It also has other methods that you can use on it. But today we are going to simply talk about object.create method. Now let's look at the syntax of this method object.create. It would take two arguments. The first argument is some sort of object prototype. So it will be object. And the second argument is some sort of property object. The second argument actually is optional. So using this, let's create a new object. So I'm going to call this object my object. So const my object, object.create. And I'm going to set using objects prototype, the master objects prototype. And remember, every constructor has a property called prototype, which holds a bunch of methods. So I'm going to use objects prototype to create this my object. And if I examine it using console, I would see, so I have an object. And again, here's a reference, proto_proto_proto_ is nothing but its creator, and which will point to that object's prototype. So if I look at it, I would see all these methods, and I can verify if these are the exact methods that is in object's prototype. If I do, let's say, console object and run both. So the first one is the my object, and it has a proto, and which has a bunch of methods, and this is the object constructor. And if I scroll down, it also has prototype. And it also has a bunch of methods. Constructor has property, is prototype of, which are the same methods. So basically, it's the same pointer to this object's prototype. Now, remember, when you create an object literal, so we can say const literal, it's an empty literal. Now, this actually also is created using the object create method internally. So we'll have a prototype set to object prototype, and I can examine it by, I would see exactly the same prototype reference here. Now you don't always have to set this reference. You can create object without the object prototype. You can say const no proto. I'm just gonna call this object's name, and you can say object.create. And I'm just gonna pass null to it, which means don't set any prototype. And if I examine it, I would see three objects, my object, my literal, and no proto. And I can see the first two have reference to prototype, and the second one has no properties at all. So it doesn't set the reference to object prototype. Now, one of the jobs of object.create is to create objects, right? As we see, we are using object prototype. But what if I create a new constructor? So let's create a constructor called car. So I'm just going to say const car, and it's nothing but a constructor. You can say, anyone inside it would say this dot color, color. Now you can actually create, because it's a constructor, you can create cars from it. So let's say if I create car one, equal to new car, and I'm just gonna pass the red color. So this is how I create a new car. I can do the same thing with objects.create. Const car to object.create, and I'm just gonna use cars, this car's prototype. The only difference is here in the first example, I'm running the constructor. And the second one, I'm not running the constructor. So the difference between two is it's not gonna set the initial property that constructor usually set. If I console log out, so the first car has the color property and the second car doesn't. But again, they're setting the same reference for the prototype. Now, besides creating objects, the main objective of object.create method is to extend constructors. You know how in object-oriented programming languages, you have a base class, which has some methods, and you can create a subclass, which would inherit the base class methods. So you would use something like class B extends class A, and it would basically copy all the methods into class B. Similarly here, you can extend one constructor from another constructor. So let's start with a car constructor, and I'm going to add a prototype, a method to it. So I can say car.prototype. I'm going to create this method called getColor. Let's say getColor, and inside it would just say return this.color. And remember, this is a new ES2015 syntax. You don't have to say get color equal to function. Now let's create a toy car. So which will be another constructor. So I'm just gonna say constant toy car equal to a function. This one is an empty constructor. It doesn't have anything. Now what I want is a toy car to have all the car's properties and methods. So basically, using the prototype inheritance, I want to set toy car's proto to be car's proto. And you can do it using the object.create method. So the way you would do it is say toy car.prototype equal to, and here I would pass car.prototype. So basically, this will set a reference for the toy car's proto to car's proto. So let's say if I create an object using this toy car constructor. So I can say Lego car equal to new toy car. And if I look at this Lego car, I should see the prototype reference. So I look at the toy car and expand it, I would see the get color method, which is coming from the car constructor. There are a bunch of ways to verify if toy car is extended from. One method is I would just say Lego car instance of. This should give me true, because is Lego car instance of toy car, which is correct. So if I run it, I would get it true. You can also check if Lego car is instance of car. So they both are true. And since car is actually created from object, because it's inheriting objects, the master objects properties. So you can also verify if Lego car is instance of the master object. If I run it, all three are true. There's also another method called isPrototypeOf. toyCars.prototypeProtoOf. Lego car. So this should give me true. So is toys car prototype is prototype of Lego car? And that should be true. I would get it true. Similarly, is car's prototype is prototype of toy car? that should be true as well, is object's prototype is prototype of Lego car. That is also true. So in nutshell, object.create helps you extend a constructor. Compared to classical inheritance, when you extend one class from another, you basically copy all the methods from the base class into subclass. Here, you just set a reference from subclass to the base class. So it's a prototype reference, so you don't really copy anything. In the next tutorial, we are going to look at prototype chain. And I hope you learned something from this tutorial. And if you did, please like, subscribe, and provide a constructive comment. Thank you.